गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, होप यू ऑल आर वेरी ईगर फॉर योर नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑफ योर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस. सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू स्टैंडर्ड 4 लिटरेचर पार्ट 1 लेसन 3 हेनरी द कमेलियन. स्टूडेंट टर्न टू योर न्यू मलबरी पार्ट ए बुक लेसन 3 हेनरी द कमेलियन. इट्स रिटन बाय रस्किन बॉन्ड. Ruskin Bond, 1934, was born in Kasauli in Himachal Pradesh, India. He has written many poems and stories for children. Here is what he said in a recent interview. I am shy, but it is easier to interact with children. Just the other day, a boy said he wanted to become a writer, but couldn't manage to fill even a single page. I said, write one sentence, let another go on adding. You will find the proof page full. Ruskin Bond is still alive and we are very eager for his next published book. Student, you know, have you seen a chameleon? See, this is how a chameleon looks like. It has a crest, like the fire helmet, firemen wear helmet. It has ribs. It has a long tongue as long as his body. It can change his color and it is very unique creature. Let us read a story about a chameleon named Henry. This is the story of Henry, our pet chameleon. Chameleons are no ordinary reptiles. They are easily distinguished by certain outstanding marks from their nearest relative, the lizard. A chameleon's tongue is as long as its body. On its head, it's a rigid crest which looks like a fireman's helmet. Its limbs are long and slender, and its fingers and toes are more developed than those of other reptiles. Many people believe that the chameleon is a dangerous and poisonous reptile. So, chameleon is a unique creature. We can easily distinguish them. Their nearest relative is the lizard. But how we can differentiate them? As it has a crest which looks like a fireman's helmet, and its head is very rigid, which cannot be bent or which is very hard. Crest is a top or highest top part of something. And this reptile, it's a reptile, but it can change color and it can also move its two eyeballs in different directions at once time. So it is very easily can be differentiated or distinguished from their nearest relative lizard. And many people believe that it is a dangerous and poisonous reptile. When grandfather was visiting friend, he came upon a noisy scene at the garden gate. Men were shouting, hurling stones and brandishing sticks. The cause of all these was a chameleon who had been discovered sunning himself on a shrub. The gardener declared that it was a thing capable of poisoning people at a distance of 20 feet, and as a result, the entire household had risen in arms. So, one day what happened, when the narrator's grandfather was going to visit his friend, he heard some noise and he saw that there was a group of people who were hurling stones and brandishing sticks on a chameleon who was sunning himself. Sunning himself means getting the heat of the sun on a shrub. Okay. So, and the gardener said that if anybody will come around the radius of 20 feet, then what will happen to that person? The person will be poisoned because chameleon is a poisonous creature. So, everybody was terrified by this. Grandfather saved the chameleon. He rescued the chameleon and brought the little reptile home. As the chameleon was named Henry. So from here, when grandfather rescued the chameleon from the garden and brought and saved his life, and his name was given Henry. Henry was harmless creature provided I was patient. Henry was willing to take food from my hands. This he did very swiftly. Swiftly means quickly. His tongue was the sort which came back to him with the food, an insect attached to it. Before I could realize what had happened, the grasshopper held between my fingers would be lodged between Henry's jaws. So chameleons love to eat insects, and their favorite insect is a grasshopper. It's also an insect, green color. Whenever the narrator offered him a grasshopper, within a second, few seconds, quickly he used to take out his long tongue and he used to lodge between, it would be lodged between Henry's jaws. Okay, turn to the next page. Henry did not cause trouble in our house, but he did create something like a riot in the nursery school down the road. It happened like this. What happened? Henry was very good pet and he did not disturb anybody in home. But one day what happened, due to Henry unknowingly, it created a riot. Riot means what? A group of people make lot of noise and trouble. That is called a riot. So he created a riot situation in the nearby nursery school. So what is the story there? Let us read. When the papayas in our garden were ripe, grandmother usually sent a basket of them to her friend, Mrs. Ghosh, who was the principal of the nursery school. On this occasion, Henry managed to smuggle. Smuggle means to move things secretly. Himself into the basket of papayas when no one was looking. The gardener dutifully carried the papayas across the school and took them into Mrs. Ghosh's office. So what happened? Grandmother's friend, Mrs. Ghosh, who was the principal of the nursery school, grandmother sent some ripened papayas from their garden to Mrs. Ghosh by the gardener. But anyhow, Henry managed to get inside the basket of papayas and he too was carried to the school. When Mrs. Ghosh came in after making her round, she began admiring and examining the papayas. Out popped Henry. Mrs. Ghosh screamed. Henry would probably have liked to blush a deep red, but he turned a bright green instead, as that was the color of the papayas. So what happened when Mrs. Ghosh admires the papaya, Henry popped out from it. Popped, not come out, suddenly, quickly. It means popped from the basket. And Mrs. Ghosh was so much frightened that she started screaming. And Henry tried to turn himself as he can. He's a can change color. He wanted to turn himself into deep red, but he was so confused and the color of the papayas was green that he could not do so, and he also turned himself into the green color. Mrs. Ghosh's assistant, Miss Daniels, rushed in, took one look at the chameleon and joined in the screaming. Henry took fright and fled from the office, running down the corridor and into one of the classrooms. There he climbed on the desk while the children ran all directions, some to get away from Henry, some to catch him. But Henry made his exit through a window and disappeared into the garden. So listening the screaming, Mrs. Ghosh's assistant, Daniels, she also came, rushed into the room and looked at the chameleon, and she also started screaming. And Henry was frightened too. He was so much terrified that through the corridor he made his way to the classrooms, and few students were also frightened and few students wanted to catch Henry, but anyhow Henry managed to exit from the window and disappeared in the garden. Grandmother heard all about the incident from Mrs. Ghosh, but did not tell her that the chameleon was ours. I did not think Henry would find his way back to us because the school was three houses away. But 3 days later, I found him sunning himself on the garden wall, and he readily accepted some food from my hand. So what happened? He managed to disappear into the garden, and Mrs. Ghosh said everything to grandmother, but grandmother was relieved that Mrs. Ghosh could not identified that chameleon was their pet, and the narrator was very upset because the school was too far from their house and he thought that he will never meet the chameleon again. But 3 days later He saw Henry again sunning himself on the garden wall, and he was happily accepting the food from the narrator. And so this was the story, student. We'll look at the summary of the lesson. Henry the Chameleon is a short story by Ruskin Bond. As you can make out that from the title itself, that Henry is the name of a chameleon. One day when Bond's garden gate ready to kill a poor chameleon who was out for sunning in winter, he was bitten by the gardener and rescued by the grandfather. Grandfather brought him home and named him Henry, and he became the friend of the narrator. When Mrs. Ghosh, the principal of a nursery school, got the papaya from narrator's grandmother and was examining, she found out Henry, and she was so much frightened from the chameleon that she started screaming. But anyhow, Henry was so confused at the reaction of the ladies, that the principal and the assistant, that it got frightened and it ran away from the window. The incident reached up to the grandmother. She have a sigh of relief, as no one could make out of the chameleon was theirs. After a few days, Ruskin found Henry sunning on the wall of the garden. Thereafter, it lived there and kept reducing the growth of insects. So, what is the moral of the story? The moral of the story here, we can say that the writer has written it in simple and lucid way. And this story is a satirical in nature, but highlights the human-animal relationship in most funny. And here, moral of the story is the Ruskin Bond has opposed the myth that all animals are poisonous and dangerous, and they can too become our friend, and we can have a healthy relationship with them. So student, what is your work? Your homework is that you will write all the word meanings that is given in the book in your school note copy, that is in page number 41, 42. Okay, so all the word meanings you will write in the school copy. You will learn the lesson thoroughly. You will practice the reading, and your homework is this one in page number 40 also. In the book only, you have to match the animals with their stories. Okay, so this is all for today. In the next part of the video, we will give you the question and answer. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.